eyes are receptive, my heart is open. My hands are receptive to.
Begin to appreciate the Lord. Tell him, I love you, Jesus. Tell him, thank you for all that you have done. Tell him he has inspired you already today to go and pursue, to go and overtake, to go and recover all. What else do you need? What else do I need than the testimonies that were given today? Hallelujah. Begin, open your mouth. I'm expecting you to open your mouth. Our God is here. Our God is here. Take your glory. King of kings, take your glory, Lord of lords, take your glory, King of kings, you belong to you, my God, it belongs to you, my God. Take your glory, King of kings. Take your glory, Lord of lords. Take your glory, King of kings. It belongs. The word of the Lord that I will hear today will transform my life. Put your hands together for the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we are very grateful. What an awesome God you are. But thank you for the testimonies of this beautiful day. Jesus, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. And going into your word, Holy Spirit, go with us. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says the entrance of your word gives light and gives understanding to the simple. I request, Holy Spirit, that you make us the simple. The Lord will make you the simple. If you are here, say amen. The Lord will make you the simple. Only the simple will win. The Lord will make you the simple. In the mighty name of Jesus. The word of the Lord will have a resting place in your heart. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us all be seated. I want to welcome you again to Koga Cathedral. It is my prayer that the blessings of the Lord will go home with you.
Amen.
Tap your name and say the blessings of the Lord.
Do
it one more time. The blessings of the Lord will go home with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Today the Lord wants me to speak to you on the first part of three parts messages titled The Chronological Sequence of the Events Leading to Eternity. Chronological Sequence of Events Leading to Eternity. Tap your neighbor and say chronological sequence.
Chronological sequence
of events
leading to eternity.
Chronological sequence
of the journey
to eternity. Let's open our Bibles to the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, we are all going to read from verse 13 to 17. The book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, from 13 to 17. 1 Thessalonians, chapter 4, 13 to 17. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
Let's go together, all of us. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if you believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord, we by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him, with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall be. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
People of God, the Lord has sent me to go and remind you that our Lord Jesus Christ is coming back. And his coming is very soon, is very close by. Today we have a mixture of so many things in this world that we have. But there will be a day when it comes, when the chaff will be separated from the wheat. It will be the day of the Lord. And I have come to let you know and draw your consciousness to the preparations that we need to make sure we are going through. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today in this world, sinners are coexisting with saints. In this present world that we live in, the bad and the good, they are coexisting. In the present world that we are in, the believers and the unbelievers, we are coexisting. But one day, can everybody say one day?
One day.
Jesus will come back.
Jesus
is coming back to cause a separation. And the separation is that he's going to call his own to one side. And the ones that are not his own will be separated from his own. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My prayer for you is that when he comes, he will meet you watching.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whenever he comes, you will not be found wanting.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Many have said he's not coming back. Many have said we've been waiting all this while. I just want to encourage you, people of God, to know that when whatever he says, is able to do. And whatever he has already spoken is going to bring to pass. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Apostle Peter warned us in the passage that we read today, 2 Peter chapter 3. He told us that we must not take his delay in coming for slackness. Tap your neighbor and say, our God is not slack.
Our God is not slack.
He is giving you and I the opportunity to repent, opportunity to turn to him, opportunity to see whether some of the chaff will become wheat. But there will be a day that that opportunity will cease. Hallelujah. It is called the day of the Lord. Hallelujah. 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9 says, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some count slackness, but is long suffering towards us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There will be a day when there will be two words. One is going to be heaven, the other one will be hell. It is now for me and you to do what we need to do by working out our salvation with fear and trembling, knowing fully well that at any point in time, our Lord Jesus Christ could appear. Hallelujah. They will find you ready.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
They will find you ready.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Matthew 13 verse 30 says, let both grow together until the harvest. And at the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tears and bind them in bundles to burn them. But gather the wheat into the barn. One day is coming when Jesus will come to separate his own from the ones that are refusing to become his own. Hallelujah. But the opportunity is available to all of us. I want to encourage you. Do your soul searching. Accept him. Walk with me. With him. Travel the journey with him. And you will gain eternal life. Tap your neighbor and say you will gain eternal life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Write these three nuggets down. These are the facts that you must know about his second coming. Number one, rapture is not the second coming. Rapture will occur before the second coming. In the area of the second coming and the journey from now to eternity, there are a lot of pollution, a lot of teachings, but as a church, the duty of the minister is to line it up for you, for your understanding, so that you will not be swayed, because the Bible says false prophets are going to come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Rapture is not the second coming. Rapture will occur before the second coming. Number two, at the second coming, our Lord Jesus Christ will touch down and reign here on earth. It's not something that is given to imagination. He's going to physically touch down on earth here. And he's going to reign here on earth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But at that time, he's coming. He would have separated the one that belongs to him and the ones that are not his. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number three. Every believer, including you, all of us, we will have two chances to enter eternity. Our God is an equal opportunity God. You are going to have two chances to make it. But may I submit to you that the first one is better. Hallelujah. Tap your neighbor and say the first one is better.
The first one is better.
Hey, that second one ain't any joke at all. The first one is better. Anyone that waits for the second one is going to save himself by his own blood. The first one now is better. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There are 12 events that will lead to eternity. We are going to take them in these three services one by one. 12 events. The number one event is the end time occurrences. Do not let anybody deceive you that the tribulation period is here. Not yet. This will be a joke compared to what we are talking about when it comes to the tribulation period. The end time occurrences, they are already upon us. God has sent me to go and tell you that you and I must walk out our salvation with fear and trembling. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The book of Matthew chapter 24, open it. We're going to read together 36 to 39 at that time. Let's go together. But of that day and hour, no one knows. Not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark and did not know until the flood came all the way. So also will be the coming of the Son. It will be a surprise on that day. The Bible says two will be at the meal, one will be taken, one will be left behind. Even though God did not tell us the exact day, the exact time, the exact hour, but I want to let you know that the scripture gave us some clues. The Bible gave us some clues. Things that we are going to begin to see that signal to us that the end is near. Hallelujah. Number one of them is that sin will get to its climax. Have your neighbor and say this. Sin will get to its climax. I was anyone that is a Christian, that is a God-fearing Christian, will chiver about what is going on around us. I saw on the internet a woman that was marrying her dog. Sin will get to its climax. People will begin to do that which you thought was no human being in their license will do. And they will claim that they know what they are doing. Sin will get to its climax. 20 years ago, if anybody says that gayism will be legal in America or in any country in the world, it's spreading like fire now. The end is here. Hallelujah. End time occurrences. You have to make a decision. Where do you want to spend your eternity? I want to reign with him. If you read chapter 15 of 1 Corinthians very well, if anyone misses it or misses it, No. All of the service and donation and dancing, you don't want them to be in vain. Hallelujah. Amen. You will make it.
Amen.
You will make it.
Amen.
My brothers, you will make it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. What shall he promise a man? You gain the entire world and you forfeit. It will not be your portion.
Amen.
Sin will climax. That's number one. Signs that the clues that the Bible gave us. Number two sign is that there will be wars and rumors of war. Mass killing, terrorism, all of these occurrences that we are seeing now that sound and look strange, they begin to happen. That's what the Bible says. And that is telling us that we are closer than when we first started. Hallelujah. Tap your neighbor and say, walk out. Anyone that departs before Jesus comes, his own book has closed. It is where you got to. That is why it becomes dangerous. Maybe you say, I have tomorrow. I have tomorrow. I have tomorrow. The day your book is closed, that is what you are going to be judged by. You will not be damned.
Amen.
Say better amen to that.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number three, sign of the end time. Number three. What is called liberalism will be on the rise. Any of us know what we call liberals? The people we call liberals, there are very many in New York State. We know what liberals versus conservatives.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
They are more democratic than Republicans. They are liberals.
Yes.
Anything goes. We can walk naked in Times Square. It's okay. The Constitution allows us to do anything. It is a sign of whatever amendment we are quoting. Liberalism will be on the rise. In 1992, the people that did poll, they identified in America that 19% identify themselves as liberals. In 2014, that 19% became 25%. Then the question is, what are the Christians doing? If our preaching is effective and is enough, 19 should become 13. Hallelujah. Because our goal is to depopulate hell. But because the Bible predicted it, that it is going to be on the rise. Right now, we have 38% of America that says they are conservatives. 34% says they are moderate. Depending on how I feel, I could be conservative, I could be liberal. I could be conservative, I could be liberal. But majority of them are really liberals. If you add it to the 24%, it becomes over 50% of America. And we're drawing closer. We are drawing closer. Because the Bible says that God himself cut short the number of days because of the elect. Otherwise, before you and I become liberals, before you and I begin to say, okay, it's okay. Before you and I begin to do things that are despicable, he decided to cut short the days. You will make it.
Amen.
I will make it.
Amen.
You will make it.
Amen.
Mark 13, verse 20. And unless the day the Lord has shortened those days, no flesh will be saved. But for the elect's sake, whom he chose, he shortened the days. We are closer than when we started. Tap your neighbor and say,
we are closer
than when we started. Number four clue is that there will be famine and earthquake, natural disasters. Some people were asking here on Saturday, on Wednesday, there will be natural disasters all over the place. Occurrences that are massive. Occurrences of people dying. Occurrences of people losing their lives. You will not partake in them.
Yeah.
Let me try this place. You will not partake in them.
Yeah.
You will not partake in them.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus. They are signs of the end time. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Daniel prophesied about the end time also. But before we go there, let's read 21, Luke 21, 8 to 11. Luke 21, 8 to 11. Luke 21, 8 to 11. The book of Luke 21, 8 to 11. Let's go together. And he said, let's go together. And he said, take heed that you, for many will come in my name saying, I am he, and the time has come near. Therefore, do not go after them. But when you hear of wars and commotion, do not be terrified, for these things must come to pass first, but the end will not come immediately. Then he said to them, nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be great earthquake in various places, and famine and pestilence, and there will be fearful signs and great signs from heaven. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's coming back. It's coming back. It's coming back. Will you be ready when the Lord shall come?
Oh,
I will be ready. I will be ready. I will be ready when the Lord shall come. I will be ready. I will be ready. I do not want to walk in vain. I will be ready when the Lord shall come. It is greater than what you can imagine. It's going to come like a thief in the night. Some will be surprised, but the ones that are prepared, they will just be happy because they are already ready. They have done all that it needs to be done. Hallelujah. The Lord will meet you watching. You don't understand that prayer. The Lord will meet you watching. The Lord will meet you watching. This is where it becomes very dreadful. unrighteousness before. If they suddenly turn to become righteous,
that's it.
And the trumpet sounds, they are going to make it. And the ones that were righteous before that turned into unrighteousness. The Lord will catch you watching.
Yeah.
You will be prepared.
Yeah.
The book of Daniel chapter 12 verse 1 talks about it, as I'm going to read. And at that time, Michael shall stand up, the great prince who stand watch over the sons of your people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was seen there was since there was a nation, even to that time. And at that time, your people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will prepare you.
Yeah.
Jesus will prepare you.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus will prepare you.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
The opportunity is here now. If you seize the opportunity, you only help yourself. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number two occurrence is called rapture. Number two. We're going to 12. We're going to touch those two. Can everybody say rapture?
Rapture.
Say rapture.
Rapture.
Tap anyone and say rapture.
Rapture.
The Bible describes very vividly what will happen on the day of rapture. It is not a thing that you're figuring out. It is very vivid on that day. The Bible says on that day there will be a series of occurrences. Series of occurrences. Series of occurrences. And suddenly Jesus will appear in the sky. Don't forget, the same way he left is the same way he's coming back. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 to 17. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. Just like the day of Pentecost was sudden. Just like the day that Jesus left was sudden. It will be a sudden occurrence on the day of his coming back. You are going to see. The Bible says that number one on that day, there will be a shout and the sound of the trumpet. Whether you believe him or not, you are going to hear the sound. Amen. Equal opportunity, God. Whether you accept him or not, you are going to hear the sound. It will be a dreadful day for some people, but it will be a day of joy for some people.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Soon or very soon, we are going to see the Lord. Soon or very soon, we are going to see the Lord. Soon or very soon, we are going to see the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we are going to see the Lord.
On the last day,
oh yes, Lord.
On the last day, oh,
that day will be altar. And on that day, some people are going to hear, I know you not. That will not be your portion. After you have served the Lord, you have worked for Him, you have done all of this. And suddenly now, the day of reward came and you're not making it. You will make it. You will make it. In the mighty name of Jesus. Work out on a daily basis your salvation. With fear and trembling. You will hear the sound. Everyone, all eyes will see Him.
That's right.
The Bible says this same Jesus, as you see Him go, all eyes. It will not be there explaining to us that He just came. No, you will see Him yourself.
Yes.
The Bible says that He's going to appear in the cloud.
That's right.
All eyes will see Him. All eyes will see Him. The ones that are dead in Christ. Your parents, your loved ones, the ones you thought you're not going to see again, they will rise.
Hey.
They will rise.
Oh yes, Lord.
They will rise.
Hey.
They will put on celestial bodies.
Hey.
They will reign with Him.
Yes.
I would say they will be caught up with Him in the sky.
Hey.
The ones that are still living, that are believers.
Yes.
Hey, we will also be quickened.
Hey.
Yeah, my spirit. Hey, my emotion.
We will put on incorruption.
Yes.
And share this body of corruption.
Yes.
We're going with Him.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Guess where He's taking us? To a great celebration.
Amen.
A great celebration.
Amen.
There's a banquet in heaven ready.
Yes.
Hey, you don't want to know what will happen to the left behind.
Yes.
Hey,
yes.
Don't even imagine it. If you think ISIS is putting someone in a box and setting fire on that such person, don't imagine what will happen to the left behind. If you think that they are cutting someone's neck, and you think that one is horrible, don't even imagine what will happen to the left behind. It will be a day of dread. A day of dread. A day of dread. I want to encourage you, people of God, walk out your salvation with fear and trembling. Today is the day of the Lord. Tomorrow might be too late. I want to encourage you, embrace Him. When you embrace Him, you have nothing to fear. You'll be ready, and He'll be ready for you. I'm going to read the 1 Corinthians, remain standing, we're going to go home. Chapter 15, verse 52 to 54. The Bible says, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must be put on incorruptible, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruptible, and the mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
It will be a glorious day.
Yeah.
You will make it.
Yeah.
I will make it.
Yeah.
You will make it.
Yeah.
You will make it.
Amen.
You will make it.
Amen.
I will make it.
Amen.
You will make it.
Amen.
I will make it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not serve Him in vain.
Amen.
You will not serve Him in vain.
Amen.
You will not serve Him in vain.
Amen.
You are going to pray. You are going to talk to God. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19 says, nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal. The Lord knows those who are His. And let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity. You are going to talk to God. It's a serious matter. He says He knows His own. It is not by saying, I am dying, oh Lord, I am dying, I am dying. No! He knows His own. People say, am I dying, oh Lord? No! He knows His own. He's going to separate the ones that are not His.
Yes.
The pretenders.
Yes.
The ones that come to act.
Mm-hmm.
Only You are going to pray and tell Jesus. You're going to tell him, help me to do your will at all times.
Help me to do your will at all times.
It's as simple as that. Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Help me to do your will at all times. Shall we pray? Amen. In the name of Jesus. The reason is that settles it. The Bible says, you are my friends. Mm-hmm. If you do whatever I command you. John 15, verse 14.
Yes.
It is not by saying I am a Christian, it is by doing. If you do his will, you belong to him. You are his friend.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You are going to pray. The Bible says, let everyone that names the name of the Lord depart from iniquity. Hey, 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 hey. The day of the Lord. Let everyone, now is the time to depart. Every secret sin. Nobody sees me. Hey. Every form of unrighteousness, it is now to depart from them. Work out your salvation. Live your life for him. On a daily basis, and you will have nothing to fear.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I told the people in the morning, I said, to some of those hospitals where people die, when the hour and the time is coming, they scream with agony. Whereas there are some people that are just at peace with themselves because they know where they are going.
Yes.
If you are not sure, anyone that is not sure is going to scream. Because now, preachers have said their own. Pastors have preached. But now is the day of the real action. The Lord will save you and I.
Yes.
You are going to tell Jesus. You are going to tell Jesus to release you from every sinful nature.
Amen.
He can do it. Release me from every sinful nature. Every part of me that is quick to run towards sin. Every part of me that is quick to accommodate sin. Lord, release me from their heart. Shall we pray? Open your mouth. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, my life is in your hand. My life is in your hand. My life is in your hand. Release me. Release me from every sinful nature. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. When they talk about earthquake and this and that, they are human beings that we have to go through.
Yes.
You are going to tell Jesus the suffering of now, Holy Spirit. Separate me and my family, shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus. My life is in your hand. That's where I want to live. Watch over me, separate me from the sufferings of now, the end time sufferings. Last prayer. We prayed it for you during the men's night vigil. Exodus 12:36 concerning this week. And the Lord had given the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians so that he granted them what they requested. Thus, they plundered the Egyptians. You are going to ask for favor concerning the week that we are in now.
Yes.
And the Lord will grant it unto you.
Yeah.
Hear these people of God. Hear this. Hear this. This God that we serve in Koga Cathedral, no one should joke with him. I call upon him concerning a client of mine, 1990 whatever to date trouble. We knew the ops, but I told God, surprise these people so that I can talk to them about you. We knew what the trouble was. We got to the interview. The interviewer said, you've been here before. You've gone through this 2 times already. Errors are on the file, so many of them that were committed. So, you filed again, okay. Asked the first question, the second question, and told them, I am not feeling it. I am not feeling it. I am not feeling it. Repeated it over and over and continued to ask, I am not feeling it. I am not feeling it. At the end of the day, when the book was about to close, the lady looked up like this and said, no, I am not even going to take you through that headache again. She changed her mind. That was the last time. She changed her mind on the dot of closing the book. That's when you know that what we call God is nothing to be joked with.
Yes.
Said, I am not going to put you through. I wrote it in my file, exact words. This trouble again. I am going to approve it.
Amen.
Just said it like that. And the man said, you have just given me back my life.
Hallelujah!
Oh, God, you lost back my life.
This week you will find favor! In your own case this week. Before God and before man, your case will be approved. We pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.